Okay, so looks like Chip is gonna be doing this by himself today. Oh my, my. I think Pastor Angie and Pastor Brown will be coming on later. But anywho, let's talk about what's going on. Okay, you guys doing great? Yes, we miss you guys. Okay, so today our lesson is about Jesus healed a woman and a girl. Oh, yes. Jesus, he's a healer. He can heal you. Yes, he can. All right. So, Jesus healed a woman and a girl. And also, our Bible passage is coming from Mark 5. Okay? All right. So, I think last week we had a new key verse and a big picture question. Yes. So, let's see. Our Bible passage is Isaiah 53:4-5. Do y'all remember that from last week? Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgression. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace. And with his wounds we are healed. Oh my, yes. God is a healer. And our big picture question is, why did God create people? Oh my goodness, that's a great one. God created people to worship him, love him, and show his glory. Okay, so we have a big surprise today. We have two of our children ministry, children that we are highlighting. Yay! I love the children at Little Branches! So, our first person coming up will be Zion. Zion, and then Phoebe. So Phoebe and Zion are being highlighted for this Sunday. If you are interested in being highlighted, you need to contact Pastor Angie or Pastor Brian or Miss Miranda. Yes, contact them. Let them know you want your kids to be highlighted, guys. Yes, this is awesome. Okay, so now you know what we do first. At the beginning of every service, it's time to worship. Jesus is the way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, and light in the darkness.
You are here, moving in. I worship you, you are here, working in this place, I worship you. Touching every heart, I worship you.
Hi, guys. How are you doing?
Hey, little branches.
Hope you liked our song. We make miracle work. Promise keep light in the darkness.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Yes.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
Chip.
Yes.
What are you talking about? Hope you liked our song. Welcome back. I hope you liked our song. I know you didn't do
Pastor Brent.
Open Up Children's Church without me again.
Pastor Brent, Pastor Brent.
What?
We already did the beginning.
What do you mean? What do you mean you did the beginning already?
Yes. I did it by myself. I don't know what happened to Kevin. He was supposed to meet me here. Mm-hmm. And you know how Kevin is. He had something else to do, so.
Wow, so you did it again. It's the second time.
Yes, I had to start it all on my own.
First time yes. You and Kevin, now it's just you. I guess Pastor Brian going to be out of a job here pretty soon, huh?
Oh, my goodness, no. No one could take your place, Pastor Brian. No one can take your place.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, Chip, so I guess you did told everybody what the Bible story was.
Yes, our Bible story was Jesus healed a woman and a girl.
All right, and I guess you went over the key verse.
Yes, our key verse is Isaiah 53:4-5.
Okay, and then I guess you went over the big picture question.
Yes, our big picture question is, why did God create people?
Well, why did he create people, Chip?
Well, let me tell you. God created people to worship him, love him, and show his glory.
Who are you looking at over there, Chip?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh. Hey, all right. Okay, well, I guess you did pretty good. I let you slide this time, but I tell you what, next time, I might have to write you up, Chip.
Oh, my. Don't write me up, Pastor Brian. I don't want any demerits. You're going to give Chip some demerits?
Yeah, you're not going to get snack.
Oh, Lord, no.
I know you like your snacks.
Snacks.
All right, well, let's go ahead. I guess since you did all of that, we can kind of jump into introducing our Bible story.
Okay.
All right, well, you know what? Actually, thinking about the Bible story today, I got to thinking. A lot of times, we find that over time, things can wear out. Like, think about maybe like your toys, for example. Do your toys ever wear out and maybe sometimes even break?
Oh, yes. You know, I won't call the name of the store, but, you know, some stores you get those toys from, they be broke the same day, especially with tough kids like me. Toys just broke. Them store, you know those toys, Pastor Brown, that cost a dollar? You know what I'm talking about?
No, I don't know about no toys that cost a dollar. Well, actually, I do. I was thinking about getting you some toys for your birthday from there, but I guess since you're talking about it like
really?
That, I guess I won't.
Oh, okay.
Okay, well, anywho.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even our bodies sometimes break, Chip.
Yes.
Sometimes our bodies just don't function right. They don't work right. Has your body ever, like, not worked right?
Well, I would say when I'm sick.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, other than that, Pastor Brian, Mommy says, you have a lot of energy, boy. Go sit down somewhere.
I bet she does.
Yes, I have energy.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Focus, Chip. Focus, 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 focus,
him.
Focus. We got to keep on going. Focus.
Oh, I'm sorry. Pastor Brian, you know I love Jesus.
I know you do.
And I love to sing.
Yes,
hallelujah.
I know you do, Chip. But you got to focus, man. You got to focus.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
Hey, Chip, so like even our bodies, you know, like my body kind of sometimes doesn't function right. Sometimes it wears out. A lot faster than it used to because, you know what? I'm not a spring chicken anymore.
What chicken?
A spring chicken.
A spring chicken?
Yeah.
Pastor you know that. Brian.
What? What's so funny?
You're not a chicken. You're a man.
Of course I know I'm not a chicken.
So you're a spring man then. You're not a spring man anymore,
oh,
Pastor
Brian.
Oh,
my goodness. Oh, so you're a comedian now. Oh, okay. Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, you know what I'm talking about.
You tickle me.
Yeah, so, you know, in our Bible story today, there was a woman, and her body wasn't working right either.
Oh, my goodness.
And guess what?
What's that?
The doctors couldn't even help her.
Oh.
The doctors couldn't fix her, couldn't make her right.
Well.
She was like that. She was broke for a long time. Her body wasn't functioning right for a long time, Chip.
Poor lady.
But who do you think she went to get her body fixed?
Ooh.
Don't say it, Chip. Don't say it. Ooh. Don't say it. Don't say it. I know you go to Renaissance. I know you know the answer to these questions all the time.
Ooh.
You know, because you're like the A1 student at Renaissance.
Hold it. Ooh.
Hold it. Just hold it until after the Bible story, okay? We're going to check it out in the Bible story to get the answer to that
goodness,
question.
Best friend. Let all right. me tell it. Ooh. You can't tell
okay,
it.
Okay, don't tell it. Don't tell it, Chip.
Like
hold yourself.
I'll tell it.
Okay, look, we're going to see you after the Bible story.
You can't
we're
tell
gonna
it.
Find out the answer in the Bible story. Chip, tell him bye. We're
like
going to see him
I'll
after the Bible
it.
Story.
Bye, guys. Bye.
All right, we'll see you back here in a little bit.
All right. Again, my name is Chip.
We know.
Chip.
We know, but say it one more time.
Chip.
All right.
Bye, guys.
Chip, I'm still trying to figure out, just like Kevin said, why you gotta say your name three times?
Well, I love to hear my name, Chip.
Okay, we'll see you after the Bible story.
Bye.
Jesus came to earth as a baby, but his ministry began when he grew into an adult. He traveled around healing people, teaching about God, and doing miracles to prove he is the Messiah. Last week, we learned that Jesus healed 10 men and one was saved. This week, we will hear about two people Jesus healed, a young girl and a grown woman.
Jesus stood on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, and a large crowd gathered around him. Jairus, one of the leaders in the synagogue, fell at Jesus' feet and begged for his help. "My daughter is about to die. Please come touch her so she will be healed and live," he said. Jesus went with Jairus, and many people followed, crowding around him. In the crowd was a woman who had been bleeding for 12 years. She had seen many doctors and had spent all her money trying to get better, but no one could help her. She was getting worse. The woman said to herself, "If I touch even Jesus' clothes, I will be healed." She came up behind Jesus in the crowd and touched his clothes. Immediately, her bleeding stopped and she knew she was healed. At that moment, Jesus felt that power had gone out of him. He turned around. "Who touched my clothes?" he asked. Jesus' disciples pointed out that many people were crowded around him, but Jesus kept looking around. The woman, knowing she was healed, came forward and fell before Jesus. She told him what had happened. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. You are healed." While Jesus was speaking, some men came from Jairus' house and told Jairus, "Your daughter is dead. Do not bother Jesus anymore." Jesus heard what the men said, and he told Jairus, "Do not be afraid. Just believe." Jesus and three of his disciples went to Jairus' house. People there were crying and wailing loudly. "Why are you crying?" Jesus asked. "The child is not dead. She is sleeping." The people laughed because they did not believe Jesus, and he told them all to leave. Jesus took Jairus and his wife into the room where the child was. He took the girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, get up." Immediately, the girl got up and began walking around. Jairus and his wife were amazed. Jesus told them to give the girl some food and to not tell anyone what had happened. By healing the woman and raising the little girl from the dead, Jesus showed his power as the Messiah. Jesus died on the cross and rose again to save people from sin and death. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sins and changes us to be more like His Son.
Hello, my name is Zion, and I am going to the sixth grade.
All right, Zion, if you won $100, what would you do with it?
Probably I would buy a violin if it cost $100.
All right, what do you like the most about your siblings?
Probably the fact that when I can't play video games, I'm able to watch them. Depending on what sibling it is.
Who's your favorite person in the Bible?
Probably Gideon.
What do you miss the most about Little Branches?
Tickets.
What is the most important thing Little Branches has taught you?
To love God.
All right. And cheer. Oh.
Hi, I'm Phoebe Ronwald, and I'm in the fifth grade.
Okay, Phoebe, I have a few questions for you. If you were to win $100, what do you think you would do with it?
I'd probably give half of it to charity.
Next question. What do you like the most about your siblings, your brothers, your brother and sisters?
Everything, I guess. Huh?
Okay. Phoebe, who is your favorite person in the Bible?
I guess Esther.
Okay. What do you miss the most about children's ministry?
Everything!
Hi, guys! So happy to be back to see you again this week. I hope you enjoyed the beginning of our lesson today. So a couple of things I just want to reiterate. Jesus not only healed sickness and death when he was on earth, he also took our sins and died on the cross for us. When we trust in him, we gain his righteousness. God forgives our sin and makes us new creatures who will live with him forever. Isn't that awesome? Yes. So, hope you enjoyed today. Hope you guys are having a wonderful week. I just wanted to say that we miss you guys so much. Pastor Brian was kind of busy, so I had to end this myself so we wouldn't be delayed with a video. So, hope you guys enjoyed Chip and Pastor Brian earlier. Hope you have an awesome week. I love you. We miss you so much. And we're going to end in prayer. Okay? All right. Let's bow our heads. Father, thank you for sending your Son to rescue us from sin. Help us to trust you, love you, and obey you, and obey your word. Heal us from the damage sin does in our life. God, we love you, we exalt you, and we give you all the glory. We thank you for keeping us all safe. Lord, we just pray a continued protection and blessing upon each and every family represented. And God, we just pray for our pastor and his family, and all of the pastors that are associated with Cliffdale, and our leadership and all of our members. Lord, we just pray protection and covering from all. And whoever watching, and if you're not a part of Cliffdale and you're watching this video, we just pray that God bless and cover you as well. Lord, we love you. We praise you. We adore you. In Jesus' name, amen.
I'm choose to be successful.
Love. Victory.